So let me give you an overview on what happens when I get a patient who's sent to see me because they have a positive biopsy at colonoscopy. We now know that we're dealing with a colon cancer, and one of the first steps we need to do is make sure that that colon cancer is confined to the colon and no other place. So what I typically do is order a CAT scan to make sure that there's no other intra-abdominal disease, and if there's going to be, it's usually in the liver if it's spread, if it's gone beyond the lymph nodes. Once I have the results of that CAT scan, if it's confined to the colon and or the lymph nodes, then this patient is a surgical candidate. If it's spread beyond, they can be a surgical candidate, but it's a much more involved decision to decide whether or not to take them to the operating room. So for a patient who does have a colon cancer confined to the colon or to the colon and the lymph nodes, I would take them to surgery. And the surgery that I would usually do is what's called a laparoscopic surgery. Laparoscopic means using cameras and instruments within the abdominal cavity through small incisions and then making a little bit larger incision to extract the specimen. That surgery is pretty well tolerated where patients are in the hospital for say 3 to 5 days until bowel recovery resumes, and then after that time they're going home. They're home typically for a week or two until I see them back in follow-up, and if they're doing well at their follow-up appointment, then I'll send them to the medical oncologist to discuss chemotherapy. Usually like to wait about 4 weeks from the surgery before they're going to consider getting chemotherapy because I really want to make sure all their anastomoses or I put them back together as well healed. And it takes the body about 6 weeks to fully heal from any surgery.
For an interactive tool to learn more about your colon cancer and your personalized treatment options, go to mycoloncancercoach.org.